are heading there. The whole world will probably be locked down within several weeks, perhaps.
Now, this is obviously a humanitarian tragedy, but since I am a contrarian by nature, ever since I spent a couple of years on Wall Street, where it's known that the herd, the thundering herd, is always going to be wrong at some critical juncture.
Yes.
I mean, okay. Yeah. I'm a contrarian. I try to say that, I say it as gently as possible, that this is a blessing in disguise in certain ways.
It's a
wake-up call. It's a wake-up call, just how fragile our economic system is.
Exactly.
And it needs to be replaced. And this offers, people are beginning to say, God, I wish I had some tomatoes growing in my backyard. I wish I had some lettuce. You know, people are beginning to understand the value of independence and security, food security, and how we have a fragile system when we depend upon going to Safeway or some other supermarket.
Yeah, and supply chains and things. I have a question for you with your experience on Wall Street. Do you think the global stock markets around the world will be frozen at some point?
Well, they
if we go into...
Yes, the simple answer is yes. And the example is that in one day last week when it dropped to 10 points, they stopped trading.
Yeah, the circuit breakers
in the past have stopped trading for several days in a row. I forget when the last time that happened was. But it's artificial, since they know that people tend to panic and that will tend to create a self-fulfilling, accelerating
spiral down. Yes.
They need people to cool off, stop panicking.
Yeah. Right.
The problem is, whereas before in the cases, the provocations were more remote.
Yes, less long term.
It's not going to go away. This one is going to be there.
No.
Monday morning, we're going to have more cases. Okay. Yeah. Monday morning, there are going to be more countries locked down, hopefully.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, again, the blessing in disguise is, I'm sorry that this will sound unhumanitarian, but when I've said it in email conversations, people have written back to me, back channel, saying, I didn't want to agree with you on the list, but
you can.
But it's humanitarian, in fact, because we're either going to suffer a little bit now, and the loss of life will be huge, but it's nothing compared to the loss of life that will be encountered by humanity if we don't get on top of the climate and ecological devastation that we're doing.
Exactly. That's very well said. And I can add a couple sort of things that I'm not suggesting we do, but if a hospital system is fully functional and efficient and has enough machines, if you get sick, you may have a 0.4% chance of dying, depends on your age, et cetera. You know, if the system is flooded, you know, can't handle the capacity, your odds of dying might be 4%. So doesn't that mean, if you're thinking of your individual health, wouldn't you want to get sick when the hospital is fully functioning as opposed to when the hospital does nothing? You've got a 10% better chance, right? If everybody's going to get it. So
that's like saying, that's a bit perverse, because that's like
you don't need to worry about
infect yourself with malaria because nobody else has got it now, and you'll build up an immunity. You know, I don't reckon
the hospital will be able to save you. And it's just numbers. The death rate's lower if you were to get it now. So if they need any volunteers to do any tests for, they can let me know, right? Yeah. My wife says, you're crazy. Okay, the other thing is that, you know, you hear my son in his school, there's a foreign exchange student from China. His parents live in China and he goes to the school in Ottawa. He wore like a full hazmat suit and everything to school, just kind of as a joke. And all of the kids, you know, my son, you know, 17, he said all bunch of the kids, they were pranking their friends. They were pretending to cough, sneeze. You know, these are kids, right? But these are the sort of things they were doing. And I said to my son, I said, well, you know, one thing about this virus is you know, if we do lose 5% of the population globally, there'll be lots of jobs, right? Job openings. Right? Although that's kind of perverse too, because, you know, yeah. a lot of people yeah. that will yeah. lose will be people that you know, and it'll be people that, you know, are older and they're not in the labor force anyway.
You only have to go to the movie, what was the latest Avengers movie, the two-part one, Infinity Wars.
Oh, yes, half the population, right? Yes. Right.
And that's, then, of course, yeah. you know, yeah. when the Infinity Wars thing came out, there was a meme that spread around the internet saying that Thanos was humane.
He was a hero, not the villain.
And that, yeah. It made people think a little bit, because unfortunately they cast him as a bad guy. By there was no differentiation. There was no. It was just half of every yeah. planet. Not. I mean, if he had infinite yeah. wisdom and infinite power, he could have educated everybody, you know, like,
yes, exactly.
But it came right. out of a mentality yeah. where yeah. everything grows exponentially, where population yes. doubles. So he said, yeah. and as you said before, even if you removed half of the sentient population, when I say sentient, animals are also sentient, but if you yeah. remove half of the humanoid intelligence population, yeah.
right.
You're going to go back to the same thing as before. You know, you need to stop yeah, the exponential growth. You need to get people yeah. to live in harmony and yeah. peace with their surroundings, and to understand that yes. growth is not necessary for, and in fact, growth is antithetical to our living yeah. peacefully and long, happy lives. And this is something that the current economic system cannot, it's a meme yeah. that cannot be shared, because it's so antithetical to the current yes. banking system and the current economic system.
Yeah. Yes, that's right.
You know, I thought of something. I'll put it in this video and hope that I can create a meme out of it. But it's a brainstorm, an epiphany that I had the other day driving down the hill in an electric car to, not that that makes a difference.
Into town, down your hill.
Well, no, to meet someone. Yeah. Since I don't get paid for my climate work, I make my living by renting space in my house, rental yes. units. And I was mm-hmm. going down to meet someone who's a possible renter, mm-hmm. guide them in. I live at the end of a long, you know. Anyhow, the thought that I had, it came to me as a hashtag. I mean, it was boom, boom, hashtag. And the hashtag was hashtag, I don't buy that. And it's got two distinctly different meanings that you can parse. One is yes. it's known to mean, I don't accept that. That's a pile of yeah. hooey. I'm trying to yeah. avoid saying bullshit. Yeah. It's a pile of crap, okay? Yeah. I don't buy that, that's a pile of crap. I don't buy yeah. anything that Trump says, because I know he cannot tell the difference between the truth and lie, and lies more often than not, because he's worked us into a situation where he has to lie about everything. Yeah. You know, make America great again. Bullshit. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Make my bank account bigger again. Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
So, and the other meaning of I don't buy that is literally don't buy that.
Yes.
Boycott.
Yeah. It's great. I love it. Yeah.
Now, the question is, how do we make that into a campaign, a global yes. theme? Well, I need to start tweeting. You're welcome to start, because you tweet a lot.
Okay.
I never tweet.
Yeah. Okay. I'll think about that. Yeah. That's excellent. That's really good.
I'm going to start putting it in. Actually, I can go back and edit it into any of my videos in our collection that have yeah. any message about the economic system, because
right.
the way to unwind the problem from the ground up level, I mean, obviously we'd be more efficient if our governments got it, that growth economics is killing us. But if people yeah. get it, and they just simply need to stop buying so much stuff, which is yeah. one of the silver linings of the current pandemic.
Yes. Yes, the malls are closed down. My son was insistent on going to a mall. I'm in Oshawa. He wanted to go into Toronto and meet in a mall. I said, you're not going to a mall. I sent him some of the stuff about you know, this is where, you know, explaining some of the data and the trends, and you know, he's meeting his friend at their house, so I have to go pick him up in a few minutes. So we've come okay, to an hour.
We've done an hour. Yep. We're going to wrap this up. But I have, yep, a similar problem that I called on the phone and I purchased two tickets to hear a wonderful musician by the name of Taj Mahal. And there was, yes, a chance that another wonderful musician, Willie Kay, who's got cancer, yep, might, he's listed on the program, but may not make it. But they're playing this weekend at a place called the Blue Note, which has franchises in several cities, yeah, started in New York. And I've got, yeah, two fairly expensive tickets to that. Yeah. And my date canceled on me because of the, so yeah, I'm gonna probably go myself unless I can, yeah, get somebody else to go with me. And they said, well, we won't refund the other ticket, but you can put it off for another performance. But then I got to get really good at protecting myself in a public environment.
Yeah. Yes, you do. You know, take care. And I mean, the less, you know, the article I did a series of videos on, it's called Coronavirus, What You Must Do Now. And what you must do now, you capitalized and now capitalized, all caps. Now, somebody commented that it's like, it's like I was commanding what the coronavirus should do. like not what people should do to deal with it, but coronavirus, what you should do, you being the coronavirus, what you should do now. And that's like shut down humanity so climate has a chance to recover. That's how he thought I had a double meaning for the title. But I wasn't actually thinking of it that way. I was thinking more that politicians, governments, they have to shut stuff now.
Yeah.
We have to do the social isolation. It's the only way to clip the exponential curve and stuff.
And that is so antithetical to the economic, yep, program that governs, yep, every industrialized nation in the world. Every yes, industrialized nation that has a banking system,
yep,
that's,
yes,
controlled by a central bank.
Yeah.
The nature of that economic system is you got to, yep, keep it growing or it stalls out and collapses.
Yeah, exactly. Just Google coronavirus bloodbath. It's all about the stock market, the financial markets, you know, that's the bloodbath. Okay. It's nothing about people.
Yeah. Yeah. There you go. Right? Well, yeah. Got it.
It's perfect. It fits right in with what you're saying. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, anyway, it's been wonderful.
Yeah. We've had a very rich conversation. Let's let a few days go by maybe, and let's do it again. And because I think, okay, I would be willing to publish this warts and all without, you know, just slap a head and a tail on it.
Just do that. I mean, time, don't you feel an urgency, a compression of time here?
Yes.
I call it time compression. I used to play a lot of duplicate bridge. And, you know, if you play right, you make like a slam or grand slam or whatever. And if you mess up, then you do trick compression instead of getting 12 tricks, you get 11 or 10, right?
Yeah.
This is time compression because everything is happening so quickly. So don't worry about the bells and whistles. Just get this out. We'll do another one.
Warts and all. I'm going to see if there's any logical place to split it because one of the things I've noticed is that in aggregate, the audience can only handle somewhere between a third and a half of the time length. If you take a 20-minute program, they'll watch about 10 minutes, 8 or 10 minutes. But if you break that that 20-minute program into two 10-minute programs, they'll still only watch about
Is that right? Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, it goes up a little bit. And if you've got a very interesting one and if you have, you know, whatever, if you have prurient clickbait, you know, I would like to have a little sexy something or other across the screen to just keep people's attention on you know what I'm saying. Humanity is not, as we said it before, they're not cultivated systems.
Okay. So just keep your recording on, you know, for another hour, and then people will watch the first hour, and they'll watch the show, and they won't see the blank screen for the second hour.